Safety is an important part of any construction site, and that includes fall protection. So today we're going to be comparing some different roofers safety fall protection buckets. What's up, guys? Welcome to the Metal Roofing Channel. I'm Thad Barnett. Subscribe if you're new here. We release new metal roofing and metal construction content every Monday and Wednesday. Today, we're talking about fall protection, and we're gonna be comparing and contrasting some different roofers bucket kits. And these are all-in-one fall protection packages that are at a reasonable price. Now, we have David Ivey from Malta Dynamics, and he's going to be talking to us about some different systems as well. And for you standing seam installers, make sure you stay to the end of the video. David is going to be showing us a brand new product, a prototype that they are developing for standing seam installers specifically in fall protection. So make sure you stay to the end of the video for that. All right, let's jump into it. So the first kit that we're going to be looking at today is this roofer's bucket that I bought at Home Depot. You can go right to local locations and find them on the shelf. I bought mine online, it ran me about $99, and that's pretty comparable. A lot of different manufacturers make similar roofing kits like this one, and a lot of them come with similar items. So this includes a universal harness, a 50-foot rope lifeline with lanyard, and then it also includes a temporary roof anchor. So let's open it up and check it out. First of all, it's got the user instruction manual. Make sure that you are properly trained and that you follow and are compliant with all the rules and regulations. You can read up about it in here. Or if you want to have more information, Mazzella Companies provides a lot of fall protection training for roofers and for general construction as well. So check out some of their information online. So first of all, we have the roof anchor right here. And this goes at the peak of your roof, and you can see the attachment point here. Depending on the kit, some of them comes with screws and some comes with nails. Is that correct, David? I've seen different kits with screws and nails.
Yes, that's correct. Most of these roof anchors like that can be installed with either or, so sometimes they provide both, some of them provide one or the other.
Gotcha, yeah. So this one comes with screws. It looks like there's about 12 of them here, and the instructions should tell you how to anchor that. Also, what comes in the kit is the universal harness. So here is this universal harness, what it looks like, just like this. Here's your attachment point, which you would attach to your lanyard and rope lifeline. And then this particular kit comes with a 50-foot rope. And this is where you would attach to your harness. And then here is the rope grab where you would use to walk up and down the rope walk up and down the roof and adjust where the harness was on the length of the rope. So you can see here, this lever just slides like this and unlocks, and then you can move it up, and then when you release it like that, now it's taut on the rope. And the rope comes with a knot in the rope, and you wanna leave this here because as this comes down, it'll stop when it hits the knot like this. It has your min max numbers here for weight limits. It also has your max free fall information and different manufacturer's instructions as well. It also has a fall indicator. David, can you tell me what a fall indicator is and what that does?
Yeah, so the fall indicator is used to show if there's been a load applied to this. So if you're working on a job site and somebody were to take a fall or have any other load applied to this, that fall indicator, it'll deploy. And what that'll show the workers to remove from use, because if there's a load applied to this, it needs to be removed from service. Before moving on.
Okay, so does every lifeline lanyard like this, are they all one-time uses for roofing?
Yeah, so if you do take a fall on them, you are required to get rid of them.
Gotcha.
They're a one-time use. Once that deploys, there's no way to put it back together.
Okay, now additionally, because this kit does come with a universal harness, and everything all in one, that's a benefit. But it can also be a downside in that the universal harness might not actually fit everyone, and it's really important that you have the right fit. The rope might not be the right length that you want. You can run into some different issues like that with an all-in-one kit like this. David, can you tell me about what some other companies like Malta offers when it comes to wanting a customized roofing safety fall protection system?
So some of the products we offer in our bucket kits, like you have there, we have different sizes. So we have the small, medium, large, universal, like you have. We have an XL, 2XL, and then a 3XL. And then we have an extra small one on the, you know, in production right now. So that'll be releasing soon. So we have that. And then we actually have some different models of harnesses. So that's a very basic harness. We have some upgraded ones, with some upgraded buckles, added padding, some belts and stuff added on, some more of the bells and whistles to added comfort and things like that for the end user.
Gotcha. So yeah, let's take a look at this harness right here. What would be some things that would be different from this harness and maybe one that you guys could supply, somebody could custom order?
So we have a harness basically very similar to that, that's identical to it, other, you know, collar and stuff like that, but visually, it's hypothetically the same thing. So then the next harness we have here that we can supply with them is, this is our tongue and buckle. So what that means is the legs here, the legs have a belt strap on them. So it's nice because you can adjust it. If you're wearing different clothes for the day, if you're working in Florida one day and you're up in Alaska the next, you know, the different clothes will be on there. So it's nice. So you don't have to adjust it with threading the webbing to and from to make it adjustable. We also have reflective stitching and things like that in the harness. So added visibility.
And what would be the price difference between something like that and something like this harness that comes with the kit?
The price difference on something like that is very minimal. You're only looking at, like, let's say a $10 price difference, okay, give or take, okay, depending on size and stuff like that, but it's very minimal. So then we have, basically I have one more harness here I can show you. We have some more in between kinda, but, it's generally, they either go from the one step up or just kinda straight to the top when it comes to those. So we have our Comfort Max harness here. So as you'll see, we have a breathable shoulder pad in it. Quick connects chest buckle, so it's ease of getting in and out, and then a back pad on here. It's gives you the lumbar support. It's got the side D rings. This does have reflective stitching in it, and then the legs on it actually are the quick connect buckles as well. So it's really nice, very comfortable. This is our Comfort Max harness, and then so if you're upgrading from one of those up to this, you're looking at, you know, like a $60 to $70 difference. But for those workers that are in them all day, a lot of times they're willing to pay that upcharge just so they're comfortable. We can also put them in a bag. So some people prefer not to tote around a bucket because, you know, they're hard and heavy sometimes. So we have a bag here. And we have a thing where if you buy 60 or more of these, we'll print your company logo right on the side of them.
Yeah, awesome. Yeah, I can definitely see, you know, spending hours in something like this might become uncomfortable, and something like that would definitely help that comfort level and productivity at the end of the day for sure. Are there any differences in ropes, you know, length, material, anything like that?
So the ropes, the rope material, it'll be about the same.
Okay.
But we do have we can go 25 foot, 50 foot, and then we're coming out with a 100 foot rope here soon.
Gotcha. So do you have any advice as to, you know, how to properly train your crew? If you bought several of these, you know, what are some resources where they could go and check out? How would they know that, you know, they would be training their crew properly?
So the first thing we like to refer to is your user's manual. So you'd want to, you know, read and understand the user's manual is the first step. And the next thing would be, you know, your competent person on the job site would want to sit down and talk it over with the crew on, you know, after what they come back from the user's manual, things like that. But most of your manufacturers, Multidynamics as well, we have, you know, different training programs, whether it be 2, 4, or we could even set up a webinar like we're doing now and to talk through how to use stuff like this. Just the standard bucket kits like this, they don't require a whole lot of training. They're pretty easy to use and simple. That's kind of why they were designed that way, is get them out on job sites and get people safe. One thing to note on these is a lot of people like to use them as fall protection, is what they think of what they're using. The best way to use these is in fall restraint. So if your roof edge is 10 foot away, if you adjust your rope grab to be, say, let's say 9 feet, so you can't reach the roof's edge, you're in fall restraint, so you can't even fall over the edge. So it's a nice thing is, you know, the hierarchy of controls, if you can remove the fall hazard, let's do it.
Yeah, that's a great point for sure. Now, as I said before, there's a lot of manufacturers that make roofing safety system kits and buckets like this one as similar items. Multidynamics has one as well. And again, like we've been talking about, you can customize all these different components to your specific needs through Multidynamics. So check them out at multidynamics.com if you want more information on that. So David, thanks so much for taking a look at some different components for us. Talk to me about your standing seam prototype. I know we have a lot of standing seam installers who would love to hear what that looks like.
So we have a prototype here. It's gonna be on the market here soon. It's in production. So basically what it is, it's got a swivel top. So it's nice. So you could, you know, position to a certain port on the roof. And then when you're there, if you want to go to one side or the other, it just rotates with you. It's installed by, you have the set, you have these set screws. So you just tighten it down on the standing seam of the roof. Because we know not all roofs are created equal. So you can't just use something on a wooden roof compared to a standing seam roof. So this is our prototype, and it'll be out here within the next few months.
Awesome. And so a big difference with that particular product is the swivel, correct?
Yeah, that's one of the biggest ones compared to the ones out on the market. And a nice thing about the standing seam style roof anchor is there's no penetration. So all you're doing is tighten it around the standing seam of the roof, and then you don't have to worry about any waterproofing or anything like that.
Like the standard roof anchor that comes with the bucket kits gets screwed into the roof, but for a standing seam application, I can see how that would work perfectly with no penetration. Well, thanks to David from Multidynamics for helping us out and giving us some education on roofing fall protection systems. For an affordable all-in-one package, there's a lot of different options out there to get your guys safe on the roof. If you want some customized solutions or all-in-one kits, check out Multidynamics online as well. Comment down below if you have any questions. And as always, subscribe here to the Metal Roofing Channel. I am Thad Barnett, and we will catch you next time.